of God, men and women of God, let me tell you something else. As it relates to what's in our garden, whatever is in our garden, whether it's good seed, bad seed, undeveloped seed, weeds, another universal rule, another universal principle is this: what we feed is what will grow. It's right there in verse 8. It says, those who live only to satisfy their own sinful nature will harvest decay and death from that sinful nature. But those who live to please the Spirit will harvest everlasting life from the Spirit. There is a part of us, can we be real? There's a part of us that want to feast on things that feel good but are no good for us. Paul describes it as a battle within ourselves. Paul, you know him, responsible for approximately 12 books of the Bible. Depends on how you feel about the book of Hebrew, but you know him. He says, despite how the Lord used me, despite the knowledge that I have, he says something that helps us see the struggle of humanity. He says, for I do not do the good I want to do. Instead, I keep on doing the evil I do not want to do. And if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I who do it, but the sin that lives in me. So this is the what? Principle that I have discovered. When I want to do good, evil is always present. Men and women of God, every time we want to do good, there is evil always present. That's why we must be careful what we feed our flesh, and we must be intentional about what we feed our spirit. I know you've heard it before, but I'm going to tell you again, you can't watch CNN and Fox News all the time. You can't eat the fat back in ham hock all the time. You can't watch Real Housewives all the time, because all that you're doing is feeding this stuff into your spirit. I know you think you big and bad. You can handle all of the crazy stuff you watch on TV. I know you think you're big and bad. You can handle all that mess that's on your timeline, but it's trash. You're putting garbage inside your spirit, and if you want to grow spiritually, you got to stop doing some trashy things. Can I talk to the men in a PG-rated version? Because I know that we have some children that are watching, so I'm going to use a little bit of code. If you are looking at something on your phone and you gotta hide your phone when your boo come back, if you're opening your phone at 2 o'clock in the morning looking at something you ain't got no business looking at, it's a struggle that all men have. We just don't like to talk about it. But what I'm telling you is that you'll put some nasty stuff in your flesh, and ultimately your flesh will rise up and be the same thing that takes you out. Men and women of God, I ain't gonna stay there too long. I'm gonna wait till we get in a private conversation. So I'm gonna get going on over to the other side. Alternatively, the Bible reminds us that if we feed our spirit, we will feast on the fruits of the Spirit. If we feed our spirit, we will feast on the fruits of the Spirit. Men and women of God, it's in Galatians, the chapter right before we got to where we are this morning. Paul reminds us that the Holy Spirit produces the kind of fruit in our lives that we need every day. The Holy Spirit produces love, and agape love, which means unconditional love. The Holy Spirit produces joy, the type of joy that the world didn't give and the world can't take away. When you look at it in context, this type of joy is the proper recognition of the grace and favor of God. That's why you have joy, but because you recognize that you are the recipient of His grace. I wish I had some folks that have some joy. Then it talks about another fruit of the Spirit, being peace in the middle of everything that you're going through. I know that you want some peace in your life. So if you feed your spirit, you will eat on the fruit of peace. Peace here is a state of tranquility. It's a rested spirit. Dr. Lynch blessed me real good when we were in Bible study this week. He talked about the fact that he'd rather have peace over productivity. Men and women of God, he is not saying don't don't be productive. But what he was reminding us is some of us get so caught up in the hustle and bustle, we've lost peace. And if you want to experience peace, it comes with a rested spirit. But you got to feed the spirit if you want some peace. And then it goes on to talk about patience. Patience is the endurance, the constancy, the steadfastness, the perseverance to hold on, especially in the middle of trouble, especially when somebody's done you wrong, especially when they deserve a right hook, the two-piece and the biscuit. But patience will make you hold on to it and don't deliver the evil that they deserve. That's what happens when you feed your spirit. Can we talk about kindness? Kindness is moral excellence in character. If you feed your spirit, you will have moral excellence that will keep you when you can't keep yourself. Listen, I know I talked about some sin. I talked about it because I know that we all deal with it. But if you feed the spirit, you will walk in moral excellence that will keep you when you can't keep yourself. Then it talks about goodness. This is the type of goodness that comes from the Lord. I wish I had some folks that understood the Lord's goodness towards you. You don't have to tell me, but I know that he's been good because you are hearing my voice. You've done enough not to be here, but he's been so good to you, he kept you anyhow. And then it talks about faithfulness. This type of faithfulness is beyond your confidence level. Many times we confuse confidence with faithfulness, but a fruit of the spirit as it relates to faithfulness talks about the fact that faithfulness is a gift from God that cannot be produced by people. Faithfulness is what the Lord births within you, and it allows you to walk in his will. This gift of God called faithfulness is a special gift. It allows us and it ensures us that we will always be in his will. Faithfulness is going to do what God has called you to do when you don't have the resources to do it. Faithfulness is going to do what God has called you to do when everybody said you was crazy. Faithfulness is doing what God has called you to do when your friends turn their back on you. Why am I so faithful? Because great is his faithfulness towards me. Oh, I'm almost out of it. But another fruit that you will feast on is the fact of gentleness as described in the text. Gentleness in the text, in the fruit of the spirit, does not mean that you are weak. It means that you are balanced. A gentle believer has that right mix of force with that right mix of reservation. Y'all know I like to quote the 90s, don't you? It's kind of like when Pac said, I ain't a killer, but don't push me. It's that right blend of force, because every now and then you gotta stand up when you see wrong in your community. It's that right blend of force when you say, I'm gonna stand up for what's right. I'm gonna stand up for inequality. I'm gonna stand against racism. I'm gonna stand against sexism. I'm gonna stand against everything that comes against us being united as a people. That's what it looks like. But it also helps you to know when to sit your tail down, when to go home, when to put it in the Lord's hands. And last but not least, the fruit talks about self-control. This is the only kind of control that I ever want in my life, because the self-control as a fruit of the spirit is the type of control when you are being controlled by the power of the Lord. In other words, there are some situations you thought you controlled yourself, but it was the spirit that was in you. It's because you've been feeding your spirit. You say, you know what, I'm not gonna respond to this email just yet. You know what, I'm not gonna text this knucklehead back. I'm gonna take my tail home. I'm gonna sit down, because God is in control of the situation.